Around the globe, retailers are exploring new real-world formats that provide e-commerce-level interaction with the shopper, and they also remove friction from the store experience. Hello, I'm Piers Fawkes, and in this video we meet the Sensei Tech team as they walk me through Continente Labs, the first automated store in Europe.
So joining me today, I have Barbara Martins and Philippe Josue. And they're both at Sensei, and they're going to talk about the technology and the customer experience that they have implemented at Continente Labs, which is in a residential area in Lisbon. And it's a brand new store. And I can't wait for you to take us through it and take us on a tour. Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Great.
So
nice to see you, Piers.
Nice to see you too. So tell us a little bit about the store and what's happening here.
Yeah, so we've really focused on a very human and a seamless customer experience. The idea is that the customer can get inside the store, just touch in, and then forget about the mobile phone and just go inside the store, grab what he or she wants, and just leave. And that's it. Super seamless, no scanning whatsoever. So you can be with your both hands free, with your eyes, just exploring everything around you in the store. And that's a very ergonomic, very, very human-centered interaction kind of experience that we want to provide, you know, help our retailers provide. So yeah, so I think it's a very exciting experience. It's very simple. There's a lot of complexity behind it, but the complexity behind it just powers simplicity and seamlessness.
So it's not it's not actually a techie store, it's just a normal store. It's a really pretty store, actually. It has all the produce that you can find in another kind of like residential convenience stores. And you can pretty much do your purchases in like 5 seconds. You need to read the QR code, and then it's up to you to choose the products or to put them again in the shelf. You can return them. You have the payment method associated with your account, and then you just leave in like a few seconds after, you can have the receipt on your account.
Yes, the idea here was to get rid of two things that are, you know, a heritage from the barcode operations and technology that came into retail in the middle of the 20th century. And basically it just, you know, it barcodes and scanning mean queues and mean that people are focused on the wrong thing, right? So we really wanted to provide an experience that is all about the people interacting with the products inside the store, and actually being able to shop at occasions where they otherwise wouldn't, right? Because you can just be crossing by in the street and then you think, oh, I need bread for tonight. I can just grab the bread and leave. And that was 15 seconds rather than, you know, queuing at the till and whatnot. So
this is, this is really relevant in terms of the, like in a pandemic year like this, and if you think about it, contactless payments has increased a lot, app downloads increased a lot, so people are more keen to like touchless systems. So this is really a system that provides you total freedom to touch everything that you don't need to touch, cash specifically. So it's like more convenient, it's really difficult.
yes.
And there's nothing like this in Portugal or even Europe right now.
Yes. So yeah, we're the only tech provider that has been able to open a fully autonomous, scanless, checkoutless store with a traditional retailer, open to the public, in Europe. So we're very excited about that, and very excited that we were able to do that with our partners Sonae and Continente. Yeah.
That's wonderful. So could we have a walk around? Can I see some of the experience?
Yeah, let's do that. So basically all you need is a phone with your QR code. Yeah. You just unlock, get in. Barbara will get in as well. Then all you need to do really is So there's all sorts of assortment in a normal convenience supermarket. For instance, if I was to take this bread, I'll just pick it up and leave. And that's it. I get my receipt in the app, and that's just it. I could just leave and that's it. You know, super seamless, super focused on the customer experience. And very importantly, if Barbara could show that, there's not the technology is not.
Yeah, really, it's pretty seamless because it's in the ceiling. As you see, there's like cameras in the ceiling, the black ones. They are pretty discreet. I can hear you now. And all the shelves have like sensors that can measure weight and movements. And that's what allows you to pick up things and return them back if you don't want them. And then just go and have the accurate receipt on your account like a few seconds later.
But as you can see, so the cameras, that are, you know, the heart of the technology are really super small and not super noticeable. So
can you show me the receipt on the app?
I'll be able to do it. One thing I could show you as well, actually.
Yeah, please.
Is there's a number of integrations inside the store. For instance, there's a coffee machine here.
Yeah.
And what I could do is I could just, grab a coffee. Yeah, the machine would just, get you a coffee and I could leave. And that coffee is seamlessly integrated into my journey. So there's a number of, actually one of the core strengths of our product is how well it integrates with a number of, things that retailers may already have in the store, like be it the payment, the ERP system, or you know, a number of integrations such as this one that they already have at Continente, and you know, this easily integrates with our receipt, and then you know, I could just leave, and the coffee would be on my receipt. Yeah. So.
And you'll get charged. Can you show me? Can you show me any other functionality?
For instance, there's no cards.
That's important, actually. There's no cards.
But there's bags. So if you come in without expecting it and you don't have your own bag, you can grab one and just take your shopping. Then you have the obviously the fruits and vegetables and like fresh produce. And you have the alcoholic. And for this kind of products, you need an assistant to open the door because of the DH control, okay? Brilliant. After that, so this is pretty much like a digital panel that we have here. You have the alcohol gel, of course, pandemic times. And then you have like a cosmetic and hygiene products. The corridors. Oh, there's another detail that is really important. Like the price tags are electronic as well. So one of the features is that there's this staff app. The staff has one mobile. I don't know, like a TPA, where they can have all the info about stockouts and misplacement products. And one of the features is that you can change prices digitally. You don't need to change paper. And this is one of the advantages of this.
It's fully integrated. Like we said, you know, the good strength of the system is that it fully integrates all that change pricing with everything that is happening inside the interaction environment.
So for them, it's like a big optimization in terms of work and business management.
Yes, because the store, but one thing that we think is very important, and I think we've stressed this, but it's never enough to stress, is that the store, the idea of the store is that you humanize the interaction between the store associates and the customers. So the idea that these store associates, they are, you know, in similar numbers to what a traditional store would be, except obviously this store of the same size has more space, has more range, because there's no area being used by the checkouts, right? Yeah. And these associates are actually freer to help people, to assist them to convert sales, yeah, but also to help them find what they want or even suggest things. Yeah. So, you know, we think that's a very powerful aspect of the humanization of retail and of the importance that physical stores will still have, you know, and the pandemic was a great example of that.
Sorry. While at the same time, they have like digital tools at their disposal that allows them to make a better work, because you don't have to look for misplacement products. The store will tell you, the system will tell you that there are some like milk package out of the place, and they will immediately be able to replace it or to put it in the right place. And that's really like an optimization of their work that allows them to be really concentrated on the client side as well.
Yes.
Yeah. Really, so let me just go until the end of the store. So this is all like desserts, vegetables, like trees, projects. And then we get back to Philippe.
I'd like to know what Sensei's role is in the creation of this store. Mm-hmm. You're an independent technology company that has been hired by Continente Labs to create this?
No, we're an independent technology company that has been hired by Continente on this occasion for this particular store. We do have other streams with other customers, but this is the first one that we've opened. And our role is essentially to be the technology provider that enables the autonomous store experience, whilst also delivering a number of operations management and retail insight aspects to the retailer. So essentially on our side, what we do is we install all the technology inside the store that is basically comprised of cameras and computer vision, and also some, we call it sensor fusion, which is other sensors that are embedded in the store. And basically we install those sensors and also the computer mainframe technology that obviously supports and processes all that data. By the way, one important aspect is that all the data is processed locally in the store, and it never ends up in the cloud or is dependent on the internet. Everything is done locally and processed locally. Okay. So we basically install that technology and also run the software layer that enables that deployment. So essentially what we do, what our technology does, is at the end of each journey, sends to the retailer system what is the list of the items that went for customer X. And that's what we do. Everything else, so the operating the store, the choosing the store
inventory
range and the replenishment and everything that the retailer normally does to operate, replenish, supply chain, and everything. And obviously customer, it's their own customer, the database and everything. All the customer, you know, end to end of the value chain of retail is the customer. We only provide the technology that powers the automation plus insight layers.
The idea here is to give them the digital tools to make them compete with the digital giants. So autonomous stores and the system like this allows all kind of retailers or all kind of stores, like new or existing, to have a system that provides a better, much better shopping experience while optimizes the retailer business operations. So we are the providers, not the retailers. We partner with retailers to help them do this jump into the future.
Okay. So can you tell me a little bit about the technology that's been used? How are you tracking what the shop is picking up and taking?
Yes. So basically, our technology is mostly based on computer vision. We have put more than 150,000 hours of engineering development over the course of almost 3 years with a lot of PhDs in computer vision from all sorts of world-class universities such as MIT and Harvard and so on. And so basically what we've done is really perfected the computer vision software analysis side of analyzing image. A very important thing for us is that being in Europe, and we're the only tech provider of autonomous stores that A, has delivered a real store open to the public, and B, we're the only one who is based in Europe. And in Europe, as you know, we have the GDPR, so the regulation on data protection. And so basically, this is very important for us because from the beginning, our technology was developed with GDPR and privacy at heart. And it's something that we really respect at the heart of our technology. So basically, that provides for the fact that, for instance, we're never capturing any sort of biometric data or face data or anything like that. The only thing our technology is doing is essentially matching the QR code that you touch in when you get into the store to a journey or to a session, say, and then basically it tracks that person, which is just basically one ID inside the store. It's not recording anything in particular about that person in particular. It's just like giving it a random number. And then basically all the system is doing is as you pick up the stuff from the shelf or put it back on the shelf, it's just building a virtual basket, a virtual cart of everything that you have picked up. And basically, the way it works is it counts everything as you take it out of the shelf. So the hand that took it off the shelf is the hand that is going to be billed for whatever you took. So even if you give it to someone else after you took it from the shelf, it's you who is going to be billed. So you can get in with someone. You can actually get in on one account with, for instance, a mom with two kids, and they all can pick stuff and be on the same account. It's super seamless. Our store really, I think we created a customer experience that is super, super human. Another aspect that I really wanted to focus is that this store is actually, for the store size that it has the typical number of store associates as a store of this size would have. The thing is that those store associates, rather than three-fifths of the store associates being just stuck behind the checkout, they're actually at the entrance of the store helping people. They're in the middle of the store helping people, and they're actually keeping a store fully replenished because our system also makes sure that there is an operational backbone. So there's an app also for the store associates, and that app does things like alert them about items that are about to be out of stock and that ought to be replenished. So, and then we also have a number of analytics that the retailer can see about on-shelf availability, interaction with products inside the store. And that's very rich as well, but obviously is rich from the retailer side in an aggregate way. It never looks at individual customers. It gives insights on how the retailers can operate a better store, from an optimization standpoint. But that's pretty much it. So,
but very quickly on that last point, does any of that information get passed back to the brand manufacturers? I guess it's up to the retailer.
Yes, that's up to the retailer. That's up to the retailer, and that actually has to do with the contractual agreements that the retailer has. Normally, as they operate any store of their kind, it's not specific to this particular kind of store. This is a kind of practice that retailers may have normally, right? But it's not specific to this kind of store. Okay. Right. Yeah.
Barbara Martins, Philippe Josue, thank you so much for taking us to the call today. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.